Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 14.6 Beta 3. This is available to developers, and usually by the time this video is out, it's available to public beta testers as well. Now, this came in at a fairly small 345.9 megabytes on my iPhone 12 Pro Max, and it was anywhere from just under 300 megabytes to just over 300 megabytes on the iPhone 11, iPhone 7, and then also Apple released iPadOS 14.6 Beta 3, WatchOS 7.5 Beta 3, tvOS 14.6 Beta 3, as well as macOS Big Sur 11.4 Beta 3. So all of those are available now to developers and soon to public beta testers. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go home, go to settings, go to general, then about. As you can see, the build number is 18F5065A. And with the A at the end of the build number, it means we're getting very close to a finalized version. And so with this version, there's a few new features in it. And the first thing is a modem firmware update. So if you were having connectivity issues, whether that be with an iPhone 12 Pro Max or any of the iPhones here, hopefully this resolves that issue. If you were having problems switching between 4G and 5G, or maybe even slower signals and then back to 5G. Hopefully it resolves those issues, although we'll have to wait a few days to know that 100%. Now there are a couple things you can see as far as what's new in this one. And the first thing is the first time you open the App Store, you'll get a new splash screen. Now I've already opened it obviously, but I took a screenshot and it says what's new on the App Store and Arcade. And it says app privacy details. Learn how developers may handle your data on app product pages so you can protect your privacy. Apple continues to push privacy, and if we just go to a random app here, maybe we'll go to a game, wait for it to load. We'll just pick this one and scroll down. You can see we have the information about data. Now, we've known this for some time. It's just letting us know a little bit additional details or things like that about it. Now, if we open up podcasts for the first time, we'll go into podcasts, give it just a moment, and we've got a new pop-up or a splash screen that says Apple Podcast Subscription. Support your favorite podcasters and unlock ad-free listening, bonus episodes, and more. Also podcast channels. Discover all of the shows from your favorite podcasters in one place. So if we click continue or tap continue and scroll down, you've got all of the different things you're used to with the sort of redesigned version of podcasts, and it's looking better and better. And the nice thing is, let me find it here on my 12 Pro Max. And the nice thing is, we're going to have subscriptions soon. Now, you don't have to participate in this, but if you want to support different creators with podcasts, it gives you different recommendations. And I haven't really seen any subscriptions yet, but they should be coming very soon, according to Apple. So you will get that pop-up here, and it just helps you better find the different types of podcasts you listen to. Now, thanks again to my friend Steve Mosier for helping point out a couple details within the podcast app. And if we go to library, and at the top here, you'll see it says downloaded. Now, prior to this, it actually said downloads. So it's a small change there. Also, if we go into a show page, in the upper right, we have three dots as a menu. If we tap on the three dots, you'll see there's some additional options. On the right with Beta 3, it now says remove downloads and also mark all as played. So there's a couple new options there. And if we tap on remove downloads, it says, depending on the availability from the publisher, you may not be able to access the item again after deleting, and then you can tap remove downloads if you want to. Again, if we tap on mark all as played, you get a similar pop-up that says this will mark every episode of this show as played, and then you can mark the episodes as played. So a couple small changes there, nothing huge, but it's nice to see them continue to refine podcasts and sort of get it to the place where I may be able to use it full time instead of other apps as well. Now, another change is maybe you're using Apple's new AirTag and you have it paired to your iPhone, but you can't figure out where it is and it's lost. If you go into the Find My app under Lost Mode and you enable Lost Mode, under Lost Mode, tap on Continue. You now have the option to enter an email address along with a phone number. Before, you just had the phone number. Now you can use an email address as well if you'd like to do that. So it's just a small update as they continue to refine what they're doing with AirTag and any other features they have in Find My as well. Now, in addition to this, there's also some changes within the code, such as if your mobile network provider offers Apple TV Plus subscriptions and free trials, Apple could check your phone number to determine if you're eligible through your mobile network provider. Now, additionally in the code, there's mentions about WatchOS if you're having a problem maybe installing an update. So if you go into the Watch app and maybe you're trying to install the next update and you're having an issue, there's mention in the code that maybe if you're having an issue to install the WatchOS update, you could unpair your Apple Watch and then pair it again in the Apple Watch app on your iPhone to help install that if it was causing a problem. So it looks like we could have something like that to help if you're having storage issues or maybe something else. So there's not any specifics about this yet, but there is code mentioning that you would be able to do something like that if you were having issues. Now, Apple also said that they fixed an issue during startup where iPhones may experience reduced performance. So maybe you were on iOS 14.6 before and performance was really slow and sluggish. I know quite a few people had this issue from time to time, and it seems like it's performing well. This is the iPhone 7 in jet black. And if we go to listen now, we'll just let it load. And performance definitely feels different in this update. So they fixed whatever was causing that, and it seems to be much faster. It doesn't really matter which device I'm using here, whether it be new or old, it definitely feels faster than before, at least in the small amount of time that it's been out. So that's a big improvement. And for whatever reason, something was causing that problem and it's now resolved. Now, as far as green tint or any of those issues, well, Apple has not mentioned anything else that they've resolved in this update. So if you're still having green tint issues, it's probably going to be in a future update where they fix it, but they haven't mentioned it. Apple did fix green tint on the iPhone 11 Pro Max last year, but in August. So it took a long time with the 11 Pro and 11 Pro Max to resolve that issue. So if you're still having that issue, they fixed it a little bit with 14.5, but it seems like they're still working on it. Now, as far as resolved issues other than the green tint, I've actually noticed Bluetooth seems to be much quicker at connecting and things like that. So whether you're connecting to a car to unlock your car, like my Tesla, for example, it's extremely fast. I just go out and open the door before I had to wait with 14.6 beta 2, also with AirPods. So if you have a pair of AirPods Pro, open them up, give it just a moment, and they connect right away. So you'll see it connected pretty quickly. And in the past, I was having issues where it didn't recognize that these were my AirPods Pro. So that has been fixed with this update as well. So there's definitely some fixes going on. And I know Bluetooth is a big concern for a lot of people. So hopefully that's resolved in this update. Now, as far as iPadOS 14.6 beta 3, well, there's nothing new other than what I've already mentioned. This seems to be a common theme with these updates. And I don't think we're going to see anything new until iOS or iPadOS 15, where they'll do something major with the iPad as far as widgets and a redesigned home screen that's rumored and much more. So I think at this point, everything's okay here, but battery life continues to be an issue for me. I've talked about this at length before, but if I go to the battery life on my iPad Pro over the last 5 days, I'm only getting about 5 hours of screen on time with this device. It should be getting closer to 10. Battery health isn't an issue. It's over 96%, and it seems to be just something going on in the background. I've tried different versions. I've tried completely wiping the device and starting new and then restoring from a backup. So it's fast and fluid, no issues there, but battery life is suffering on this iPad, but it could be better with 14.6 beta 3. It will just take a few days to know that for sure. Now, battery life on my iPhone 12 Pro Max, well, that's going to take again a few days to know for sure. Switch over to dark mode here. And if we go to battery, you'll see my battery health is at 100%. And for those that regularly ask me, updates do not reduce this. They just sort of recalculate what the physical capability of the battery is. So it's not reducing the maximum capacity, it's just rechecking it. So mine's at 100%. I've used it every single day just about since the release of this phone. And yesterday and the day before, I didn't have great battery life. I had 1 hour and 56 minutes of screen on time, 2 hours and 37 minutes of screen off time, and used about 40% of the battery. That means I'm only getting about 6 hours of screen on time. However, when I go to bed at night, I have over 50% of my battery life left. It's only down to 73% because it installed an update. I ran benchmarks on this as well. So it seems like It's still suffering a little bit as far as that goes, but maybe it's just not calculating it properly. It's actually good on some days it's not, as far as what it's telling me. So we'll have to wait and see. Again, it takes a couple days for things to finish in the background to know what it's going to be like overall. Now let's take a look at the benchmarks. So if we go into Geekbench here, we'll go over to Geekbench, and you'll see I scored 1,598 for single core, 4,205 for multi-core. I ran it twice. It's actually doing quite well. You can see I ran it twice here. It got a little bit higher the first time on the single core, but a little bit lower the second time on multi-core. So as things finish in the background, it sort of speeds up generally, and it's doing quite well compared to what we had even in November of 2020. So it's actually holding up quite well. Let me show you all these devices so you could compare with what you have versus what I have. So we'll go into Geekbench here, and from left to right, I have the iPad Pro 12.9 from 2020, followed by the iPhone 7, then the iPhone 11 and the iPhone 12 Pro Max. And again, these are just general ideas of what your performance should be like. They could definitely increase a little bit over time, as these were run within an hour or so of the update. And that leads me to, should you install iOS 14.6 beta 3? And if you're on beta 1 or beta 2, then definitely I would say install it. And then also, if you still have issues, report them in feedback. This feels much faster than the previous version to me so far. And like I said, Bluetooth so far seems to be improved. So those are definite benefits of it, as well as a couple small little feature changes as well. Now, as far as when to expect iOS 14.6, well, beta 3, it seems like they're pushing them out on Mondays at this point. We could see a release candidate as soon as the end of this week, with maybe a final release the following week. And the reason I say that is macOS 11.4, for example, has support for the new iMacs, which are said to ship on the 21st. If that's the case, we need that version. The same is true with the iPad. The new iPad Pro with the mini LED display needs iPadOS 14.6 based on the code. However, they could push a smaller update to take care of that. But basically, at this point, it's released with the features such as the podcast subscriptions that Apple was talking about in their earlier April event. So all of those things seem to make sense as coming out next week for a final release. So we could see a release candidate as soon as this week or next week at the latest, I would think. Apple always, of course, can change this up, but at this point, that seems to be what they're doing, unless they have different plans that they change last minute. So that's everything in iOS 14.6 beta 3 so far. If I find anything else, of course, I'll do a follow-up with more features and things like that. And if you've found anything else, be sure to let me know in the comments below. And if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.